Hello, bookish friends. Welcome to my March wrap-up, part one. In this video, I will talk about the five books that I finished in the first 14 days of March. And like I did in my previous wrap-ups, I will insert the clips that I recorded right after I finished those books. Today is the 3rd of March, and yesterday I finished my first book of March, which was Bir Kedi Olsam by Buket Uzuner. This book was also translated to English as To Be a Cat. I read this book for middle grade March, as well as for the aim of making a Turkish video in middle grade March. In this book, Can is the only child of a family, and he really, really wants to own a cat, and his mother tells him that he could have a cat when he's grown up and when he turns 7. With persistence, he convinces his mother to own a cat with the help of his grandparents. Can finally owns a kitten and really, really becomes very, very good friends with that cat. He questions whether cats do have a better life than humans, since they can do whatever they want, they do not have to go to school or wake up early. When one day Can wishes to be a cat so much, things take a very unexpected turn. Buket Uzuner, the author, is a very famous author in my country, and she is the author of many books that I love. Actually, she is the author of my favorite Turkish book, which is Uzun Beyaz Bulut Gelibolu. So I was very, very interested in her take on middle grade, and I quite liked her writing again. Content, on the other hand, was a bit more geared towards earlier middle grade audience, which is a target age that I sometimes find a bit challenging. But overall, I really liked being in Can's mind, who's only 7, and he sounded so much like 7, only 7, which was not the case for many of the middle grade books told from the point of view of a child. So that was a big advantage for this book. On the other hand, the plot was very, very predictable. But since I'm not a target audience, I do not think this as an unsuccess. Overall, I based my rating half on my enjoyment level and half on the quality of the book, and gave Ah Bir Kedi Olsam by Buket Uzuner a 7 out of 10. Today is the 8th of March, and I finished the first book that I was reading for March Mystery Madness, which was Bir Katilin Güncesi by Kim Yong Ha. This book was originally written in Korean language, and I listened to the Turkish edition. In this short book, we follow the thoughts of a man who has been a serial killer in the past, but now has Alzheimer's disease. In this jumble of thoughts, we follow his pursuit of a serial killer who has very recently emerged, and he suspects that serial killer is going to kill his adopted daughter. Listening experience of this book was very, very interesting and a very fulfilling experience for me, because I knew that I was in the mind of a unreliable narrator, but I had no idea how unreliable he was. He claims that he does not feel any guilt towards his past actions, but his guilt was felt all throughout his thoughts. Being in the mind of an Alzheimer's patient is always interesting because you realize while the narrator has no idea that he is not making any sense when he clearly has no idea that his mind is playing tricks on him. I mean, he knows that he has that disease, but he is so sure about some of the things that we know it's not true. Although we gradually came to solve the plot twist, really liked the way that he solved this puzzle, like we are in a labyrinth. So overall, I was very, very impressed by how the story was structured. However, the emotional side of this story was very, very weak, and I failed to feel any emotion towards any of the characters. I did not even pity our narrator. That's why, although I loved how the book was structured, I gave Bir Katilin Güncesi, The Diary of a Killer by Kim Yong-ha an 8 out of 10. Today is the 10th of March, and I finished The Winner's Crime, the second book in the Winner's Trilogy. I originally started to buddy read this book with Carolyn, but because of a loss that she suffered in her family, Carolyn could not continue with the buddy read. And because I've started the book and I was almost halfway through, I decided to finish it and buddy read the third book together with Carolyn. In this book, like the first book, we follow the adventures of Kestrel and Erin. The book starts almost exactly where we left off in the first book. And I really liked that aspect of it, so that we did not miss any important details. In order not to give spoilers, I will not go into specific details. But this book is much more political than the first book. And it also has more intrigues and more misunderstandings than the first book. And things start to take a different turn towards the end of the book for both Kestrel and Erin. Like the first book, I really liked the beginning and the ending of the book. And unfortunately, like the first book, there was a part in the middle which dragged on a lot. I have to say, maybe because of my psychology, I really struggled to get through those chapters. On the other hand, towards the end of the book, it got really, really exciting, and I cannot really wait to read the third book and finish the trilogy, because I'm very interested in how Erin and Kestrel's story would end. What I really like about this book is that we see the point of view of both Kestrel and Erin, even if we do not approve. The opposing viewpoints from both of the characters, and that's what makes them so complex and so relatable and likable. Sections which Kestrel and Erin are together are of course much more dynamic and much easier and faster to read. And this book suffered a lot from the reduction of their scenes together, but that was what the plot demanded. Overall, like the first book, I gave The Winner's Crime by Murray Trotsky a 7 out of 10. Today is the 13th of March, and I finished two books back to back today. The first book that I finished was the audiobook that I was buddy reading with Nikki and Naomi. The 10th book in Harry Hole series by Jo Nesbo, which was Police. The English title is the same, Police. I listened to the book, which was originally written in Norwegian in Turkish. In this book, we follow the adventures of Harry Hole and his colleagues after the events of the last book. All of the characters try to find the killer, the serial killer of a man who kills the police detectives and police officers. And as the murders get more and more, it becomes more and more personal for all of our characters. As the chapters go on and on, we sometimes get more closer to the solution, but like in every Harry Hole book, we sometimes do get confused in many of the plot twists, which is something that I actually love in Harry Hole books. I liked Polis more than the previous book, which was Hayalet Phantom, and I loved the complex mystery plot of this book. I admired how the secondary characters in the series became so much complex and so likable, or not likable of course, and they could carry on almost 40% of the book without Harry Hole. And because the mystery was very very solid, I have to say I did not miss Harry in the beginning sections of the mystery plot, which gets more and more complex. But as the plot got more complex and more red herrings were present, it was obvious that we needed Harry Hole to solve this case. Like all of the books in the series, this book had very violent scenes, so I always try to give content warning to those scenes, even though they do not affect me so much. Some of the scenes were a bit hard to listen, even for me. And I don't know if this will be a spoiler, but it was really great that we did not see Harry battling with alcoholism and other addictive substances this time. And it was really a refreshing take on the story on that front too. And I was very very into the solving of the mystery. I listened to the final chapters with so much excitement. Even though Polis was not the best Harry Hole book in the series, it was one of the best, and I gave Polis by Joe Nesbo a 9 out of 10. And the second book that I was reading was the middle grade book that I was reading for both middle grade March and also the book club book for Kate House book club. I'm not sure if I will be able to join the live discussion because of my very unpredictable schedule. I really wanted to read this historical fiction book, which was The Year of Miss Agnes by Kirkpatrick Hill. In this historical fiction book, we follow the adventures of a British elementary school working in an Alaskan setting for a year in 1948, and we follow Miss Agnes and the other characters in the village from the eyes of a 10-year girl, Alaskan native little girl. And Miss Agnes changes the way that the people in the village looked at the concept of education with her very different and innovative methods. So it was a book full of positive messages about education. Because this book was told in a format of a collection of anecdotes, there were some anecdotes that I liked very very much, and I thought they were very emotional. But there were some other sections which felt a bit meh. But as an overall theme, it was very interesting and novel to me how people in Alaska lived in those times, because it is so much different from my country. So I learned a lot about the native life in Alaska in this book. Overall, I'm quite glad that I read this book full of positive messages and gave The Year of Miss Agnes by Kirkpatrick Hill a 7 out of 10. Those are the 5 books that I finished in the first 14 days of March. Please comment down below, have you read any of the books that I mentioned in this video, and what do you think of them? And if you're a new viewer, first of all, welcome. Please like and subscribe. Hope to see you very soon. Bye! 'Cause word of the day, I'm going to choose crime. Crime means suç in Turkish, and suç is our Turkish word of the day. Have a good day.